Hey, Steph, Phil Barber Center as a press Democrat, professional athlete. You win games, you lose games, you bounce back from whatever. Is this one going to be a little harder to bounce back for than most?
No, it's just one game. I know the circumstances are tough with that big of a lead at home, but it's the same mindset when you lose a game. It's 1-1, got to go down to L.A., take two, you know, starting on Thursday, and keep moving. So I think that's something about our team that we've been able to prove and demonstrate on a time after time. And, our resiliency has to be there. So it is tough. It's going to sting a little bit, just, you know, understanding how precious every game is in the playoff series, for sure.
Right-hand side for a Grove.
Connor Letourneau, San Francisco Chronicle. Steph, in your mind, what changed after you guys took that 31-point lead midway through the third?
I think mainly it's just our aggressiveness defensively, our togetherness defensively. You know, Lou has played amazing tonight. He had big shot after big shot, but at some point, you know, our collective kind of mindset and energy has to be there to just, you know, make it tough on him and get good shots on the offensive end as well. We turned the ball over a little bit too much. I hated my fourth foul. You know, almost 8 minutes left in the third quarter, and our whole rotation changes. A lot of little things that end up, you know, giving them confidence, and, you know, that snowball effect. And then it's just a make or miss situation the last 6 minutes, and they made more shots than we did. So, you know, it's tough for sure, considering how well we were playing up until that point.
John, front row, left hand side.
John, I think it's a 95-7 the game. Steph, it sounds like DeMarcus is going to be out a while. That's what Steve had said. If that's the case, I mean, how much do you feel for him given everything he's gone through, and what do you guys lose if he's going to be out for a while?
Well, it's tough for sure. You feel for him considering all he's been in, like you said, this last year. And, you know, this is a big stage in the playoffs. He's been looking forward to this. So I don't know the extent of the injury at this point, but you know, I hope he gets back sooner than later. But just man to man in terms of him, you know, and again, what he's been through, it's tough for sure. There's no sugarcoating, you know. You hate seeing, you know, that opportunity, you know, this, again, this big stage taken away from him like that.
Fourth row sitter, Ann.
Steph, Ann Killian, San Francisco Chronicle. You said that when you picked up your fourth foul that it changed the rotation. When you got back in the game, did you feel different? Did it change stuff for you because you'd been so hot in the first half and you struggled in the fourth quarter there?
It doesn't help, but I got to overcome that for sure. I mean, it's not the first time I've been in foul trouble. I had to come back, so you know, rhythm, timing, whatever, you got to make plays. Eventually made a, you know, big shot down the stretch. Wish I could have made one more, but I just got to be smarter and not put myself in a situation where a bang-bang call or a judgment call from the ref changes everything for us, so that's on me.
Marcus, left-hand side, far back.
Steph, Marcus Thompson with The Athletic. You guys have had some of these, you know, these not good performances, these kind of these games where it looks like you aren't all there. Why do you think it's still happening in the playoffs?
If I had the answer for it, you know, a night like tonight wouldn't happen. But this game is tough. It's hard to win playoff games, no matter what the matchup is, no matter what the history is, the regular season, you know. Team versus team, it's tough. And for 6.5 quarters, we played amazing. 31-point lead, and the wheels fell off. So I know we can get it back. We've obviously, you know, shown that level of basketball is there for us. We got to put together 48 minutes of it, and just have a collective, you know, energy and positivity around everything that we do. So again, locker room was down as it should be, because every game matters to us. got to bounce back.
Steph, Nick Cordelli, again, as the leader of the group, what do you feel like you have to do to keep everybody's spirits up, given the way this game ended and given what happened to DeMarcus?
They just rely on experience and all that we've been through this last 5 years. And we felt worse in the locker room before in terms of all the different playoff experiences we've had. So, again, that's the beauty of the playoffs. No matter what happens from game to game, it resets and you have another opportunity to build momentum. So, when we go, between now and Thursday, be real honest about, what went wrong in that second half. Make adjustments, hold ourselves accountable. And when we get on that plane, it's a fresh start for us to, again, take control of the series.
Front row center here, Mark.
SF Mark Medina Berry and his group. Regarding DeMarcus's injury and the possibility of him being out for a while, what do you guys need from the center spot with all the other guys, with Andrew and Jordan and Kevon?
Exactly what they've been doing. They've been playing amazing this last part of the regular season and these first two games. So it's kind of it's just interesting. Obviously, we signed Bose when we did. He's definitely going to help us and play obviously more minutes until DeMarcus gets back. And Lodi's been playing amazing. JB's going to get more opportunity. And he's showing he can help us. And so they're going to do it by committee, but it may look a little different considering the skill and talent and the level that Boogie can bring when he's healthy.
Back left hand side, Ron.
Steph, Ron Crutcher from the San Francisco Chronicle. You mentioned the locker room being down. Can you characterize sort of what the huddles were like in the fourth quarter, and was it anger, frustration after the game? And this is so uncharacteristic, unusual for you guys to be in this spot after a game like that.
I mean, you're locked in, still competitive during the game, so it's not like any type of crisis situation. Just try to figure out how to win the game. But afterwards, obviously, you lose. It's a tough feeling. We're talking to each other, trying to figure out, again, how we're going to move on and use this as fuel for Game three. But other than that, it's just the playoffs, man. Everything is heightened, and you got to really lock in on the fine details of what separates a winning team and a losing team in the playoffs. And we kind of lost sight of that down the stretch.
Our back left hand side.
Mark O'Collard, Metro Networks with Barry's Sports. Steph, when you picked up your fourth foul, pretty much had to step set out that rest of that third quarter, which is not routine for you. You think maybe that maybe changed your momentum, your routine, as far as how when you playing the third quarter and not being able to come out firing like you did in the fourth quarter, kind of iced you down maybe a little bit?
Again, it's not ideal, but I know how to play and should be able to pick up right where I left off no matter what the situation is. And missed a bunch of shots in the fourth. It happened. I'll be smarter next game for sure.
Great, thank you. Appreciate that. No practice for